Good evening, Facebook Live friends of Celebration Presbyterian Church. Welcome back to Tuesday evening virtual Vespers. I'm Tom Dendy. I'm the pastor of Celebration Presbyterian Church, and I've been helping host these Tuesday evening Vespers since way back in late March of last year. Sort of started as a Holy Week time, and then it just kind of continued on as an opportunity to fellowship and pray and share some scripture and song with friends over the weeks of this long and drawn out pandemic. So I took a week or two out and traveled some and saw family, and that was a real blessing. Great to see your kids and great to see them doing well. And that was a joyous time and just a change of scenery. And speaking of that, you'll notice some changes here in the Rainbow Ballroom. New tablecloth, actually not new to me, but new to you to see it here. And got a nice candle, one of those wood wicks. So if it sounds like we've got a campfire tonight, that's the whole idea. A little bit of snap, crackle, and pop from the candle itself. I see some of you beginning to gather, and I say welcome. Welcome again. Tonight, we're in the second Sunday since Pentecost, and our theme for tonight comes from Psalm 118. Psalm 118. And the theme is rejoice and be glad in God. Rejoice and be glad in God. So come on in the house. Come on in and join us here in the Rainbow Ballroom for another round of Tuesday evening virtual Vespers as we share some time of prayer and scripture and song together and a few reminders of things important in the life of our community of faith. Speaking of which, we would invite any and all of you to come join us for worship at Celebration Presbyterian Church. We're located on the Carolina Forest Boulevard, next door to the library and the Community Recreation Center. We are back in person worshiping on Sunday mornings at 11. We also are still doing Facebook Live at 11. So either way that works better for you, we invite you to be a part of our worship community. Well, we got a handful of us in the house, and we'll go ahead and get started. Our opening song tonight is coming around this theme of rejoice and be glad. It actually is a verse that comes out of Psalm 118. And the song is, "This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it." And it echoes, so it goes like this. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. And be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. Sing it with me. Well, this is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, 'cause this is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. All right. Well, as we continue to gather, we're glad you're joining us tonight for this second Sunday of Pentecost virtual Vespers on the 8th day of June 2021. And our theme, we're looking at Psalm 118, and our theme is Rejoice and Be Glad in God. If you will, bow with me now for our opening prayer. God comes into a world filled with uncertainties and darkness, and God seeks out the voids of belief and conviction. God embraces the wounded and broken, and God knocks down the walls of division and strife. God is the candle shining in the darkness of our days. God is the light of our lives. God is the one who makes all things new. So praise be to God now and forevermore. Amen. Our second song is by Darlene Sheck, and it's called Shout to the Lord. And the chorus of it goes like this. Shout to the Lord, Lord on the earth, let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down and the seas will roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the I sing for joy at the work of your hands. Forever I love you, forever I'll stand. Nothing compares to the promise I have in you. My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days I want to praise the wonder of your might.
Roar at the sound of your name.
compares to the promise I have in you. Shout to the Lord. Our scripture for tonight is a fairly lengthy psalm, Psalm 118. And I'm going to read it for you out of the New Revised Standard Version, but whatever version of the Bible you have near you, please open up to Psalm 118 and follow along. Listen, hear the word of God. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for God is good. God's steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, God's steadfast love endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, God's steadfast love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, God's steadfast love endures forever. Out of my distress I called on the Lord, and the Lord answered me and set me in a broad place. With the Lord on my side, I do not fear. What can mortals do to me? The Lord is on my side to help me. I shall look in triumph on those who hate me. It's better to take refuge in the Lord than to put confidence in mortals. It's better to take refuge in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. All nations surrounded me. In the name of the Lord, I cut them off. They surrounded me on every side. And in the name of the Lord, I cut them off. They surrounded me like bees. They blazed like a fire of thorns. And in the name of the Lord, I cut them off. I was pushed hard so that I was failing or falling. But the Lord helped me. The Lord is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. There are glad songs of victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but I shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. The Lord has punished me severely, but he did not give me over to death. Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you've answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Save us, we beseech you, O Lord. O Lord, we beseech you, give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has given us light. Bind the festal procession with branches up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will give thanks to you. You are my God, and I will extol you. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Friends, this is the word of the Lord, God's word for God's people, and it abides forever. Thanks be to God. Well, let's think about our psalm for just a few minutes. Psalm 118, thoughts on God's goodness and mercy, and a repeated theme over and over, especially in the first third of this psalm, is that the steadfast love of God abides forever. That is, that God's love lasts an eternity. There's never a time when God won't love us and God's love won't be active. That's really good news. it sounds a bit like a victory chant or a crowd at a ball game shouting out the goodness of God and the love of God is steadfast and lasts forever. God's steadfast love, in fact, does endure forever. So friends, there's a lot of good stuff here in this Psalm 118 to encourage us, to inspire us, to call out to God for help, and to know that help is available when we ask. God is listening. And to be reminded and to say it over and over, repetitively, like the psalm says it, time and again, that we're convinced that the steadfast love of God will endure forever. And then that reminder from verse 24 that this day and tomorrow and the day after that and the day after that, each day is a day that the Lord makes, and we can choose to rejoice and be glad in it. Now I want to offer a prayer at the end of our day. Lord, I release this day to you with all of its events. Thank you for the opportunity to minister to the members and friends of Celebration Presbyterian Church USA, our congregation, and to lift up the joys and concerns that have been on our prayer list. We know each person's answer is not to be found in me, but in you. I must decrease and you must increase. May your Spirit continue to pray through me, even beyond my consciousness. Enable me to rest in the fact that Christ is praying for each and every situation, and the ultimate answer for every situation is the healing love of Jesus Christ. May Christ's grace place closure on this day and cleanse away any residue that would leave an ugly stain on my mind or body. I will prepare to enter into rest with the knowledge that my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit and that my life is secure in the steadfast love of God that abides forever. And all God's people say, amen. Amen. A few reminders. I invite you to continue worshiping with us at Celebration Presbyterian Church, located at 2300 Carolina Forest Boulevard, near the library and the recreation center in Carolina Forest. We're meeting Sundays at 11 a.m. in person at the church building, also on Facebook live stream for all of our followers in this community and anywhere that the internet is allowing them to join us. This Sunday, at the close of worship, we'll have a congregational meeting, and all of our members are encouraged to participate either in person or through a Zoom link that has been emailed out today. So you can join us remotely from home, or you can join us in worship, and at the close of worship, we'll have this congregational meeting. The purpose of the meeting is to act on proposed changes to the terms of our church mortgage with the Presbyterian Investment and Loan Program. So come learn the details and help us take these needed actions this Sunday at the close of worship. Also, an outreach mission that we've been a part of throughout the pandemic and for years and years before, but we've ramped up our efforts to collect personal care items and staple foods for folks in our community who are food insecure. Neighbors right here in Horry County that don't know where their next meal is coming from. We have an anchor storage box located in our church parking lot, and it's available 24 hours a day to receive your donations of staple foods and personal care items. I'll be with you again next Tuesday, June 15th. We'll gather at 7:30 p.m. It's my birthday, and I can't think of a better way to spend my birthday, at least in part, than with you right here in the Rainbow Ballroom, gathering together for a time of celebration and song and prayer and scripture. I remind you also of the daily online devotion at d365.org, and I invite you to share your prayer request with us throughout the week, either by email or phoning in to the church office, so that we can include them to our prayer chain members throughout the week, and then on Sundays include them in our joys and concerns and our prayer time together in worship. I wish I could say that the pandemic was over, and to look around our community, you would think that there never was a pandemic because people are pretty much out and about full speed ahead. However, the pandemic does continue. There are people still becoming sick and people dying each week. So we still want to practice precaution. We encourage you, if you haven't already, to get your COVID-19 vaccinations now. Now especially since they're so readily available. It's not just for your sake, but for all of our sakes that we're getting these shots to protect each other. For those who have not been vaccinated, the CDC does recommend that you continue wearing a mask and practicing social distancing when you have to be around others. Stay in, of course, if you're having any flu-like symptoms, just to be careful. Also, the Red Cross continues to make a weekly plea for blood. If you're able to donate at this time, please contact the Red Cross. We will be having a blood drive mid-summer at our church, and we'll invite you to come then if you're eligible for donating again in July. Now listen to this benediction. May the grace of God uphold us, and the peace of God surround us, and the love of God, the steadfast love of God that lasts forever, may it flow in and around and through you, and the strength of God protect you and bring you not only safely through this day, but into the new day tomorrow. As a closing song, I'd like to share Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing.
Songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount I'm fixed upon it, mount of God's redeeming love. I raise my Ebenezer, hither by thy help I'm come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood. Oh, to grace how great a debtor, daily I'm constrained to be. Let thy goodness like a fetter bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, Lord, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above. Yes, here's my heart, Lord, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Well, friends, just a few final words of thanks and love to share. I thank you for coming back out after a couple of weeks off and finding me here and joining with me for this second Sunday of Pentecost, Rejoice and Be Glad gathering around Psalm 118. It's been good to be with you, and I invite you again to join us Sunday at 11 a.m. either live and in person or on Facebook live stream. And I hope to see you back here next week to help me celebrate my birthday on Tuesday, June 15th. And now on behalf of our church, Celebration Presbyterian Church USA, located in the heart of the Carolina Forest, I remind you all that God loves you and God's steadfast love lasts forever. We love you too. And our love is ready to welcome and receive you as you come and join with us. Now I want to leave you with one final song out of our Glory to God hymnal. It's number 177. If you happen to have a Glory to God hymnal, check it out. Join me on page 177. I will come to you. You are mine. I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fears. I will hear your voice. You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here. I am hope for all who are hopeless. I am eyes for all who long to see. In the shadows of the night, I will be your light. Come and rest in me. Not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by your name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you. Despairing, healing for the ones who dwell in shame. All the blind will see, the lame will all run free, and all will know my name. And do not be afraid, I am. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home.
I love you and you are mine. I am the word that leads all to freedom. I am the peace the world cannot give. I will call your name, embracing all your pain. Get up now, walk and live. And do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. And do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine.
Well, that's all for tonight, friends. Thanks again for joining me here in the Rainbow Ballroom. It's been a joy to be with you. And I remind us that we are going to rejoice and be glad in God, because this is the day the Lord has made. So let's rejoice and be glad in it. Okay? Take care. God bless. Know that God loves you, and so do we.